the kingdom of God is here. Open your heart, offer all, for Jesus Christ is here now. We have found
All right, happy Sunday, Cornerstone. We just had Easter last week, and I know it's always, I don't want to say different, but coming into service the following week, I don't know about you, but I tell my wife this all the time too, but Easter is one of my favorite holidays of the year, just because I think it's such a good reminder, right? Not just to us, but for the whole world, that Christ is alive, and he has defeated the grave, not just for us, but for everyone who believes. And I think that's such a wonderful message, and it always empowers me. But there's also this immediate drop the week after. I'm like, okay, Easter's over now. Now I can kind of relax until Christmas or Thanksgiving. But I really hope that's not the case, that we can all come together today to remind ourselves that we are here to worship our God. And it gave me a good time to really think back upon the first 3-4 months of this year. I can't believe it's already April. But I remember starting off the year really strong, thinking, okay, this is the year, God. This is the year that I'm going to really see you I'm going to see you move in my life differently. And maybe by now, maybe you're burdened by other things. You're like, oh man, I got to do my taxes. I gotta go to work. Oh man, I got to keep this job. I got to find the job. Whatever burden it may be, there could be so many other things that have been added onto your palette. And today, I just wanted to pray for you. And as we sing these songs, we're going to kind of do a more acoustic set just so that we can be a part of the worship together and just really hear our congregation sing together. But this is my prayer for you. So before we start, I just wanted to share this verse from Matthew 11 that everyone has probably read a million times if you've been in church. But it's, come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. And you know, I've been thinking a lot about these verses as we've been hearing about the Sermon on the Mount and what it really means to have your treasure in the right place. And I think it just comes down to, it's not God just takes away all your problems, that God takes away all your burdens, but when you focus on the right things, when you focus on His kingdom vision, on His kingdom mind, then everything else just washes away and it really becomes, it doesn't matter. I just have to focus on God and that is my purpose. So that's my prayer for you today, that at least in this moment, in this place, in this sanctuary, that we can strip down everything else and just focus on God and worshiping for Him for who He is. So I invite you to stand together. Let's worship Him.
Are you hurting and broken within? Overwhelmed by the weight of your sin? Jesus is calling. Have you come to the end of yourself? Do you thirst for a drink from the well? Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Leave behind your regrets and mistakes. Come today, there's no reason to wait. Jesus is calling. Bring your sorrows and trade them for joy. From the ashes a new life is born. Jesus is calling. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, what a Savior. Isn't He wonderful? Sing hallelujah. Christ is risen. Bow down before Him, for He is Lord of all. Sing hallelujah.
Christ is risen. Oh, what a Savior. Oh, what a Savior. Isn't He wonderful? Sing hallelujah. Christ is risen. Oh, we bow down before You. Bow down before Him. For He is Lord of all. Sing hallelujah. Christ is risen. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Oh, come to the altar. The Father's arms are open wide. Forgiveness was bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus, You endured my pain. Savior, You bore all my shame. All because of Your love. Maker of the universe, broken for the sins of the earth, all because of Your love. All because of Your love. Because of Your cross, my debt is paid. Because of Your blood, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life I freely give. Because of Your love, because of Your love, I live. Innocent and only King, You died to set the captives free, all because of Your love. Lord, You gave Your life for me, so I will give my life to You, all because of Your love, all because of Your love. Because of Your cross, my debt is paid. Because of Your blood, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life I freely give. Because of Your love, because of Your love, because of Your cross, my debt is paid. Because of Your blood, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life I freely give. Because of Your love, because of Your love, I live. Oh, because of Your love, I You did it for me. You did it for love. It's Your victory.
Jesus, you are enough. You did it for me. You did it for love. It's your victory. Jesus, you are enough. Lord, you did it for me. You did it for love. It's your victory. Jesus, you are enough. Lord, you did it for me. You did it for love. It's your victory. Jesus, you are enough. Because of your cross, my debt is paid. Because of your blood, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life I freely give. Because of your love, because of your love, because of your cross, my debt is paid. Because of your blood, my sins are washed away. Now all of my life I freely give. Because of your love, because of your love.
Man, I know every Sunday we have a moment in our worship where Pastor Joe reminds us of our pardon and forgiveness that we have in the Lord. I know just passing this Easter Sunday last week and coming in, I really hope that this means something a little bit deeper and a little bit more fresh to all of us. Before we head into that time of prayer, of just really confessing our sins and receiving His forgiveness, just really remember the cost that it took, the blood that He shed, the life that He gave, and ultimately the life that He gave through His resurrection.
In every season.
King David prayed, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there is any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." Let us ask God to reveal things in our hearts that might be offensive in God's eyes, and let's confess our sins. Let us hear this good news from Isaiah 53. "But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him, and by his wounds we are healed. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor Joe. What a great reminder. As we're standing, let's really share that peace and love of Christ with one another.
Good morning, Cornerstone Church. We're just so happy that you guys are here, able to join us today. Even though it's the week after Easter, we still have a lot of people, so that's great. You guys are still here. But those joining us on YouTube as well, we thank you so much for joining us and joining us in just really praising and worshiping the Lord together, having this corporate worship. It's not a solo act, right? We're here together as a body to really love on Christ and to really celebrate what he did. Hopefully everyone, I'm hoping and praying that everyone experienced the resurrection power last week. In a small way, in a big way, regardless, I hope you had a great week after Easter. Before we get into the announcements, let me quickly pray for the offering. Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this time, this beautiful Sunday, Lord, where we can come. We're just so thankful for this place that we can come to worship you. Heavenly Father, we know that church is not a building, but rather it is the body. It is the members that make up the church. But we're just so thankful and grateful that we have this location to worship you in the heaters and with all these great worship team and the slides and whatnot. But regardless of all that, Lord, we're able to experience this, this worship, Lord, to you and for you together as a body. Heavenly Father, we want to lift up the offering. Would you use it and multiply it for your kingdom? Would it not be out of obligation that we are, you know, offering up, Lord, this to you, but rather out of desire and out of love for you and your kingdom? Would you multiply it and use it for whatever it is needed to be used for? Heavenly Father, would you speak through our guest speaker, Lord, today? Would it not be through his own words and his own thoughts that are being spoken, but would it be your Holy Spirit that is moving through him? And would you really open up our hearts to be receptive of your word today? Heavenly Father, we love you so much. Continue to protect us and guide us throughout this week. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Alrighty, so thank you to everyone in Cornerstone, a lot of the volunteers that we had, I think I saw some guests even help us out with cleaning up and setting up last week for Easter. We're just so thankful that everyone was kind of able to corporately help out with, you know, just setting up all the flowers, all the decorations, all the kids' stuff. And so we're just so thankful that we can do that all together. And thank you for all the small group leaders who attended the small group leaders meeting yesterday. Next, we want to also thank Pastor Yeom Kim for delivering the message today and sharing a mission report from Japan. So thank you. After services and everything too, also come and say hi to him. You know, give him a handshake. Kind of, if you want to talk to him, just come and talk to him. I'm pretty sure he's a very approachable person, right? So thank you, Pastor Kim. Next, we have Cornerstone membership class. We've been talking about this. This will be on April 20th and April 27th on the Saturdays. If you want to take the next steps in becoming more involved with our church community, our church body, consider the membership class. We ask that all members take this class before serving and voting in the various voting things that we have for our church members. Next, we want to continue to remind you guys to mark your calendars for the summer retreat. It's going to be August 16th to August 18th. It's going to be at Mission Springs, as always. So just mark your calendars for now, but more information will be given later on a later date. And then today's fellowship snack is Judy. Thank you, Judy. Everyone say thank you later. And then today's cleanup crew is the college group. And with that, I will also invite up Judy for the scripture reading.
Thank you. Today is Matthew 13:45-46. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant looking for fine pearls. When he found one of great value, he went away and sold everything he had and bought it.
I just want to briefly introduce, there may be relatively new people at our church who do not know Pastor Igyeom Kim. He has been serving in Kyoto, Japan, doing college campus ministry for the past 18 years faithfully. And we, as a church, have also been supporting him for the past 18 years. And so our partnership goes, way, way back. He's just a very, faithful, consistent servant of God, and we're glad to have him. Let's give him a warm welcome. Please come up.
Okay, I should speak again. Thank you for the opportunity to share what God has done in my life and my ministry in Kyoto, Japan. As Pastor Son shared, I was supported for more than 10 years, 18 years from your church, and I could survive and keep doing the ministry in Japan, thanks to you, to your support. And now I'm going to share what God has done in my life and ministry in Kyoto, Japan, and what I expect from the Lord now on. Okay, let me start with the magazine that I'm reading in Japan, which is Japan Harvest, published by OMF. And in that quarterly magazine, probably last quarter, I received that magazine and found really good statistics written by Jody Davis. Let me read a little of that. Glimmers of hope in a seemingly dry land. I recently read a Google translation of article in Christian Today about Japanese views of religion. When Japanese were asked about their belief in God and higher powers, only 3% of Japanese answered, "I believe in God written in scriptures, Bible or Quran or written scripture," etc. Compared to the global average of 40%. At first, reading this was discouraging, but it's understandable since Japan is the second largest unreached people group. 38% said they don't believe in God, higher powers, or spirits of any kind, while 34% said they didn't know, and 10% said they didn't want to answer. And the writer says, "My glimmer of hope is for the 34% that said they didn't know if there was a God or higher power. I wish there had been a follow-up question. Do you want to know? In my 23 years with Word of Life Fellowship in Japan and a small Christian school in Nagoya, there have always been people who didn't know but wanted to know. He has hope because there are 34% of Japanese said don't know there is God or not. But I put my hope not only on the fact that there is 30% of Japanese who replied that they didn't know God or his existence and their possibility of positive change, but I put my hope on the fact that God is at work in Japanese heart. Let me share what I have recently found in Kyoto. First, I'm going to share God's active work by showing you a movie clip. It was made by Yuko Takahashi. She is professor of Kyoto University of medical in medical department, and she is also a medical doctor. Make long story short, she was called all of a sudden with the voice from heaven, and she became Christian. And she was monitoring religious activity on campus and stopped doing that. But now she is active evangelist. She made her movie file where she was doing volunteer work in Noto Peninsula, where the earthquake hit on the first day of this year. So would you turn on the movie clip? I will stop by the half.
皆さん、こんにちは。高橋優子です。私は今、能登半島の先端部分で、内科の医者として被災地の支援に入っています。少し時間をいただきまして、現状をお話しさせていただきたいと思います。被災地の状況は、皆様もすでに報道などでご存知の通りですが、震災から6週間が過ぎた今でも、道の高さに屋根があるというこの風景は珍しいものではありません。本当に多くの方が大変な震災、大変な災害に遭われたことを痛感します。ここには段差ありと書いてありますが、この歩道、もともと段差があったわけがありません。震災でこのように道路が波打ち、段差ができてしまいました。亀裂も多くのところで走っています。被災された皆さんは、体育館や公民館などに分散して過ごしておられます。今見えているのは段ボールの仕切りですが、プライバシーなどは全くない中で、この6週間を過ごしてこられました。水が来ていない、そのことは本当に深刻です。今写真に写っているのは、向こう市、京都の向こう市から来てくださっている給水車災害支援ですが、ホースから出てくる水を容器に取り、それを抱えてよろよろと自宅に戻って行かれるご高齢の方々を見ると胸が痛みます。体育館などでもトイレは使えませんから、屋外に設置されたこうした簡易トイレを使用しますが、段差があり、やはり高齢者の皆さんには辛く、できるだけトイレに行かなくて済むように、水分や食べ物も控えているといった声も聞くところです。津波のあった地域では、被害がさらに深刻で、痛みが大きいということを感じます。この方は目の前で娘さんが、そしてお姉さんが海に流されていった。そのようなことをぽつりぽつりとお話しくださいました。そして涙を流されました。私たちに何ができるでしょうか。本当に手を取って一緒に泣き、そして神様の平安を祈ることしかできません。このような方が特に津波のあった地域には多くおられます。この方は畳のところに寝ておられる方ですが、私はこの方に今何が欲しいですかと尋ねました。するとこの方が言われたのは、私たちを忘れないでくださいということでした。6週間経ったんだから、もう 支援は必要ないだろう。そのように忘れ去られることが怖いのだとおっしゃっていました。私たちに何ができるでしょうか。そのことを考えさせられます。最後に、私と一緒に活動しているジャイ。
Let us stop here. Or you can see four volunteers to work with her in that area, but we don't have enough time to do so. Later on, if you are interested in it, come to me and I'll show you more. Okay, now, secondly, God called the professor, Takahashi Yuko, come to him and serve him. All of a sudden, she was called by God and committed her life to God's work so far. And secondly, I'd like to introduce a church in Kyoto. On Sunday, right before my departure for this trip, I joined Mustard Seed Christian Church in Kyoto to give you updated news of God's work in Japan. The Mustard Seed Church in Kyoto is a great testimony of how actively our God is at work in the heart of Japanese. I had a chance to talk with the first pastor of the church several years ago. And it was not that far from the time when the church was planted. One of my associate missionaries arranged it. My words all gone. I don't know what happened. Okay, I'll come back. Anyway. My associate missionary arranged the meeting because he is one of the planting members of the church. And the pastor shared a wonderful story gladly and joyfully. One student from Kyoto University came to his church and asked to baptize him, and he was baptized in the church. He was so glad and joyful to have him in his church. And I was glad to hear of the new believer and had an envious feeling in my heart at the same time. On the next Friday evening, after meeting with the pastor, I was entering to the church where we had weekly Friday meeting, and I was stopped by someone who introduced himself with the question, Kim sensei, do you remember me? Kim-san, do you remember me? Obedashimasu ka? Watashi wa Tanaka Takahashi desu. I am Takahashi Tanaka. Long time ago, I joined this meeting, and now I return after I got baptism in Mustard Seed Church. Yes, he was the one whom the pastor talked about gladly and proudly, and let me have an envious feeling. Takahashi came to our meeting several years ago and received Christ in his life in our evangelistic event and did not show up for a long while. After he experienced some trouble in his life, he made up his mind to trust in God and the Word of God and was baptized in the Mustard Seed Church. Now he is a seminary student and graduating next year. When I visited the Mustard Seed Church, I was able to talk with one of the staff members of the church. When I asked about the church congregation, he said, approximately 130 members are gathering every week, and 70 of the congregation are Japanese. You know, 70 Japanese Christian, 130 Christian members are gathering in Kyoto. It is happening in Japan now. This is what God is doing now in Kyoto, Japan. And I'd like you to turn to today's Word of God. Actually, Matthew chapter 13 is one of my favorite. And my grandchild, Now, 9-year-old boy said he wants to be a missionary in the future. So I'd like to write a book for him from chapter 13 so that he can become a fruitful missionary. Okay, the chapter is about kingdom of God described by seven parables. And these seven parables are so precious to me and so valuable that I realized and experienced, especially in my missionary life. I can give 1 hour lecture with each parables, but today I just give you a summary and brief explanation. And the first thing, let us turn to the first one. You can find this parable in the Synoptic Gospel, the first three Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke. Can you tell me what is the first parable in chapter 13 of Matthew? Very famous one. The sower and four field or land or sowers. And the farmer, the sower, sowing the word of God. The word of God gives us wisdom and courage and hope and strength so that we can become a people of God. And it leads us to salvation and eternal life. Then what are the four soils or field or land? There are four types of soils. Three of them are of no use because of no crop, no harvest, no fruit. Only one soil, good soil, to produce crops 100 times, 60 times, and 30 times. In Luke's Gospel, chapter 8, 15, he put soil like this. As for that, in the good soil, they are those who hearing the word and hold it fast in an honest and good heart, in certain version, noble heart, and bear fruit with patience. I'll read one more time from ESV. As for that, in the good soil, they are those who, hearing the word, hold it fast in an honest and good heart, and bear fruit with patience. Let me share a story of a lady that I know the best in my life. Guess who she is? And this story shows you how the fruitfulness of Christ, disciples of Christ can be. This lady attended in Japanese church until the COVID-19 pandemic broke out. Because her church, Japanese church, announced the members not to come to the church, but join online service instead. This lady couldn't be satisfied herself with joining online service. So in a prayer, she began to attend Jainichi Daikan Kyoto Gyokai, the Korean church in Kyoto, one of the biggest ones. So each building is big and wide enough for her to join the service during COVID-19. Eventually, in that church, she met a lady who wanted someone to teach and coach her. After they met and had a Bible study for several months, the second lady led other lady to Christ through her witnessing. And then the third lady led fourth lady to Christ through her witnessing. All they are friends, but non-believers. But they came to the church. And before I came here several weeks ago, the fourth lady was baptized. This is spiritual multiplication ministry. This is happening in Kyoto, Japan, during the COVID-19. The second parable delivers the worldview for his followers to have in Christ. Do you remember what the second parable in chapter 13 of Matthew? There's enemy who spread tear like a dokumugi bad seed in the field. We must be on the alert against the enemy and evil scheme. But we must not lose our attention to focus on what we should do as his followers by knowing that the end time, the last day, it comes in God's time plan. So eschatological, difficult word, eschatological viewpoint. And the third one is the parable of mustard seed. As I said about the mustard seed church in Kyoto, it grows. Its starting point is very tiny, small, but it is growing to become like a big tree. You must grow in you, in the knowledge and faith and love of God. The fourth one is our influential power to change the world around us. We must learn how to be a good influence to the people and society around us. And the fifth one is about the action of the person who found the hidden treasure in the field. I made my commitment to Christ to own the kingdom of God since my graduation from college and joined the Campus Crusade for Christ as full-time staff with my wife. At that time, what I found was, as we sang this morning together, Christ died for me. He has forgiven all my sins through his bloodshed. So it was so wonderful. I never wanted to lose this gospel. I wanted to own this treasure as my own. So I gave up my position, my future job, and my wife also retired from her job as elementary school teacher. And then we committed to Christ as full-time staff of Campus Crusade. And the gospel itself was hidden treasure to us. That's why and how we could make our commitment to the Lord. The sixth parable is what I like the best. Now I identify myself with the merchant who seek, who try to find poorer. The sixth parable is similar to the fifth one, but slight difference is you can find. The slight difference is the fifth one, the person who found treasure in the field, hidden in the field, he found it by chance. But in sixth parable, the merchant is looking for, trying to find a good, fine poorer, because this person has eyes to see what is good or what is bad. He could appreciate the beauty of poorer. I said I'm identifying myself with this merchant. Since I committed my life to Christ and worked as missionary in Japan, God allowed me to enjoy this poorer. Think about this merchant after he purchased that fine poorer, what he could do, what should he do? Guess what he can do? Probably, firstly, he enjoyed, right? He enjoyed the fine poorer he purchased with all his belongings. And he could appreciate the beauty of the poorer, and he might talk about the people around him, or he will share his Insta or SNS. Probably somebody came to him and to sell me or try to buy it, but he never sell it again because he enjoyed that much. And when because I'm working in Japan, God allowed me to enjoy the gospel of the kingdom of God. When I preach it, this gospel to international student group, God allowed me to understand and enjoy the depths of the meaning of the gospel. people asked me, why are you coming to Japan as Korean, for Korean? They know, because they know that there is unsolved historical issue between Korea and Japan. My answer is from Ephesians chapter 2, whole chapter give me good understanding of the gospel, but let me read a little bit of it. Ephesians chapter 14, for he himself is our peace, who has made us both one and has broken down in his flesh the dividing wall of hostility by abolishing the law of commandment expressed in ordinances, that he might create in himself one new man in place of the two, so making peace, and might reconcile us both to God in one body through the cross, thereby killing the hostility. Killing the hostility, destroying the enmity, destroying the wall between Korean and Japanese, American and Japanese. The hostility was broken. When I read the word hostility in Japanese, it's deki-i. In Korean, jok-i. In Korean, old version, wonsu-den-gat, jok-i. When I read in Japanese, deki-i, it shocked me. In my heart, I had kind of deki-i. But God said, God destroyed all deki-i, hostility in himself when we sinned against, when we disobeyed God. But God removed, destroyed all enmity, hostility against all sinners. And it is the foundation and base I could embrace all others whom God put in my life, even myself. And then the last parable is about one of my precious pearls that I clearly understand because I am in Japan. I learned this story long time ago here in Bay Area. At that time, I organized big mass evangelist gathering with the guest speaker, Dr. Jungong Kim, who was founder and president of KCCC. And many pastors helped me, and I could hold big mass evangelism event here in Bay Area. And in that, during the week, that Dr. Kim invited many pastors and taught about this parable. He said, 정말론적인 전도 전략, eschatological strategy for general mobilization evangelism. At that time, I couldn't what he's talking through this parable, but when I was watching NHK broadcasting, I could realize what does that mean. You know, the last parable in chapter 13 is about dragnet fishery. People in Ireland have tradition to catch fish with dragnet fishery. While I was watching the NHK news report, there was a celebrating party in small island village because they had a new young captain of the dragnet boat. The captain of the dragnet boat was getting old and he couldn't do it anymore. So the village people wanted young captain for a long time. And finally, when they found one person, and then they had big celebration. So NHK broadcast about it. And then I tried to figure out what the dragnet fishery is, and I researched it on YouTube. If you turn to the YouTube, you can see easily. For dragnet fishery, many people need it. The captain dragged the net into the sea and then make big round net, and then many people hold both end of the net and they draw, pulling the net to the shore and catch fish like that. And when I saw that, why Dr. Kim said it is even general mobilization strategy of evangelism at the end of time, in the end of time. So this is connected to the second parable in the chapter, which is about eschatological evangelistic strategy. So the pastor of this church is a captain, and all of you are the people who pull, grab the net and pull together to the shore to catch many fishes. It is what I have been doing in Japan with many staff members and missionary mission groups in winter and summer. So, and the pastor and professor, we work all together. And then God allowed us to see two full-time staff from among Japanese students. One of them is Satomi. I think I talked about this in my prayer letter a long time ago. She joined as full-time staff. And Tanaka Takashi, he joined Mustard Seed Church as full-time. Now he is graduating from seminary school next year. And then there are many staff members in Korea and United States. After they once joined mission trip to Kyoto, many of them joined as full-time missionary or full-time staff of Campus Crusade. It is what God has been doing in my life and mission ministry in Kyoto. Now I'm asking you, from now I step down my position of city leader of Kyoto. Now my position is mobilizing missionary of Japan CCC. What I'm doing is recruiting and organizing a team and sending the team to new town or new area so that I can establish a church and Campus Crusade ministry in new area. In Kanazawa is the one of the candidate. We pray for it. So this morning, I'd like to ask you to remember in your prayer me and my project to start a new ministry in new area so that Japanese staff members could be encouraged and challenged and have the pioneering spirit with us. Thank you for your listening and prayer and support, long lasting support. So would you pray together? When we pray together, remember Japan, I said only 3% replied to the existence of supernatural God, including Allah or something else. But below than 1% are Christian in Japan. Ichioku Sanjenman, 130 million are only Christian. Among them, 1 million is Christian. So remember Japan in your prayer and ask God to bless new committed staff member Satomi and Takashi, so that they can bring many souls to Christ. And please pray for me to be able to start a new ministry in a new area. Thank you, Lord. Let's pray together. Oh God, thank you for this opportunity to pray together. Thank you for the time. Lord God, thank you so much for your blessing upon us. Especially, I'm greatly thankful to Cornerstone Church, for this church has been partner for a long time, 18 years. Lord God, thanks to this support, I could keep standing with the gospel in Japan, where so many lost souls are dying without knowing you. Lord, I ask you to be with us when we pray to you, Lord. Let us remember the lost souls in Japan so that we can do your work by the leading of the Holy Spirit. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you all.
Thank you, Pastor Kim. Let's take a moment to respond to the word. I know he shared a lot, and I think it's of 18 years of serving there. You can tell he has a heart for the nation of Japan, despite some of the political challenges we might have. And I think, you know, every time we hear these messages from missionaries, it always challenges me. Like, I put myself in their shoes, and I can't see myself dedicating my entire life. Like he just shared, he really relates to that person who sold everything to purchase that field, to find that pearl. And I don't know what that may be in your life. I don't know what God is pointing to you to really surrender and to really fully give into this kingdom-minded business. I really think it's different for everybody. And your calling from the Lord is what strengthens you and empowers you to do it. It can't be our conviction. It can't be something that we believe in our head, but it's something that God really instills in us. So we thank you for the opportunity to be your missionary partner, Pastor Kim, and as you said, for 18 years, not just financially, but hopefully we can continue to pray, as you shared, for new leaders to really rise up and to be inspired to start ministry in different cities. So if you can just really keep them in our prayers, I really hope that we can be a part of that continuing going forward. So I invite you to join. Feel free to pray if you need to pray. If you want to stand and join us and sing, please sing. But as we lift up these words to this next song, I really hope and pray that we can really become a vessel to be used by God.
In the pressing, you are making new wine. In the soil, I now surrender. You are breaking new ground. So I yield to you and to your careful hand. When I try you, I don't need to understand. Make me your vessel. Make me an offering. Make me whatever you want me to be. I came here with nothing, but all you have given me, Jesus, bring you wine. Soil, I now surrender.
failing, overtaking my heart. Take me in, finding peace again. Fear is lost in all you are. And I will give the world to tell you story, 'cause I know that you called me. I know that you called me. I've lost myself for good within your promise. I won't hide it. I won't hide it. 'Cause Jesus, I believe in you, and I will go to the ends of the earth, to the ends of the earth for you. Alone are the Son of God, and all the world will see that you are God. You are God. Love unfailing, overtaking my heart. Take me, finding peace again. Fear is lost in all you are. And I will give the world to tell your story, 'cause I know that you call me. I know that you call me. I've lost myself for good within your promise. I won't hide it. I won't hide it. 'Cause Jesus, I believe in you, and I will go to the ends of the earth, to the ends of the earth for you. Alone I'm the Son of God, and all the world will see that you are. Jesus, I believe in you, and I will go to the ends of the earth, to the ends of the earth for you. Alone I'm the Son of God, and all the world will see you are God. You are God.
And I would give.
I will give the world to tell your story, 'cause I know that you've called me. I know that you've called me. I've lost myself for good within your promise. I won't hide it. I won't hide it. 'Cause Jesus, I believe in you, and I would go to the ends of the earth, to the ends of the earth for you. Alone are the Son of God, and all the world will see that you are God. You are God.
Father, we thank you for using Pastor Yim Kim in Kyoto, Japan for the past 18 years. Would you bless him as he starts a new ministry of planting churches and planting campus ministries across Japan? Lord, help us not to be ashamed of the gospel, but to believe that it is power of salvation for all who believe. Lord, help us to share the good news in word and in deed. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you shalom. And God's people said, Amen.